Hello everybody, my name is Motherlymunkle, and today we're playing some Demoman on PL Badwater. Extra bad with the water. And here you can see me setting up some traps. So today, my main topic is the Demoman, and I'm trying to educate you and inform you on how I play the Demoman and different strategies that will help you out. So here, I've set up my traps and I'm ready to go. There's a couple of different ways you can set up your traps. I like to just set them up regardless of whether the enemy sees them or not. This can be great to really hesitate them and prevent them from pushing too quick. And that's what the Demoman's all about. Really denying the area to them and everything like that. So here I jump up here to grab some higher ground and I spot a bonked pyro. So the other thing about Demoman, it's definitely not a forward class. You can see me, I'm sort of positioning myself with a little bit of range from the objective. I'm not really getting too close, like a pyro or perhaps a spy. So, and you can see a lot of the time I'm just shooting regardless of whether I know that there's an enemy there. But it's definitely great to dish out as much damage as possible, because the Demoman certainly delivers. So I take out my good friend Frank there, the spy. I guess he's using the Dead Ringer. And the Sticky Bomb launcher is a fantastically versatile weapon. You can see me, I use it 60% of the time during this gameplay. So I'm running out of ammo here and I scour the map for some ammo, but unfortunately I run into this mini crit heavy. Yeah, I know, right? So that will take us right back to spawn. So, how are you guys going? I'm a little bit nervous. This is my first video commentary. Let me know what you think. I'm sure I'll get more confident as the time comes. So, you will notice that I've actually disabled my view models. I've been experimenting with some different configs that I've found online, which can be really helpful because I've noticed that your screen can get very cluttered in the midst of the battlefield. So, if that bothers you, just let me know. Yet again, you'll see me just spamming pills in the general direction of the enemy. And just about here, it seems as though Blue is taking more of an offensive role and they're actually starting to push the payload. So, I'm just wary here of not dying. So, this is actually a really great technique for placing pills or stickies. You can just duck in and out and it's really tricky for the enemy team to do any serious damage towards you, so that can be pretty effective. Also, you see before there, one of the demos on the other team set up a sticky trap, and I almost walked over it, but I sort of faked him just to let him detonate them, because I didn't want any of my teammates walking over that. So we get an Uber here, which wasn't particularly successful, but it certainly pushes the other team back. And I just lay some stickies here to prevent the heavy from walking past. And then a pyro comes and alights me from behind. I'm not quite sure where he came from. So I retreat to this lovely dispenser, and then I get taken out by a soldier up top. See, that can be a real issue with this map because it is quite large in terms of area, so there's lots of different locations that the enemy can attack you from. So here I'm doing some decent work with the pills, just preventing the enemy team from pushing too much, and it's going pretty well. Here, note the sticky trap, and I'll place one on the card as well. Also, and like I was saying earlier, a heavy and a medic pair come down the stairs from the flank route, which is a little bit of an issue for us. The medic pops Uber and I connect a nice pill there. So to all the engineers on this particular map, it's a really wise move to set up top as well, because it can watch over the payload and prevent too many people from flanking. So yeah, So here I'm taking a little bit of damage from various people, and this is something that distinguishes a good player from a bad player. If you're in a little bit of a struggle, and perhaps you have low health or low ammo, it's always okay to run back to spawn if you have the space and the time. So I just make a quick trip back there. And this is another mistake in the clip. I underestimate the power of that scout with the, I believe it's the soda popper. And it seems as though suddenly my team has disappeared and he outplays me there. So I clap to him. So here I'm rolling out back and you'll see a heavy and medic pair up there. So I place some stickies in their general direction. And I know he's going to be coming down the stairs, so I make a nice little trap to take them out. And, yeah, we've got quite a dense, defense line here, which is great. So, I do my job of just preventing and sort of, stopping the enemy from, walking across that area. So, this is another good choke point in Badwater, because there's not that much room for the enemy to disperse and take down our defensive line. You can see here I'm just checking all my corners to make sure I don't get attacked from the side. I get a nice crit pipe there. So I come up here to get some higher ground and all is well in the land of Badwater. Also, let me know what you think of the music choice. I've just been experimenting with different stuff. I've noticed that a laid-back approach is really easy to commentate over. Yeah, I'll see as I go. But here I just lay a quick trap in case I get caught by anyone, perhaps a scout or something. Which is always a good habit to have, and a good... it's an important mindset to have, particularly as the Demoman. So here we're doing a good job of pushing up a little bit and preventing the enemy from getting too close. And I'm saying prevent a lot. So you'll notice we push them right back and we get a nice little Uber here. And I've set up a little trap on the corpse of that body. That's also a fantastic thing to do because it definitely blocks the area and the enemy team weren't expected. So the pyro walks right into that one, which is fantastic. And here, I thought that pyro may be a spy. I was just checking that. You can never be too sure in the land of Team Fortress. So I set up the very same trap in case someone rushes our position. And I'm just being wary because I saw that heavy and medic pair go up the stairs, so I'm just being... I was a little bit unsure what was going to happen here. And yeah, I just take that pyro out and I managed to retreat and yeah. I was a bit lucky there because that was nearly quite a successful push. One of the scouts on our team got a bonk off in the heavy, which is always good. So here I'm just trying to evade the shotgun shells of that engineer. I nearly died there, but yeah. Always make sure to retreat as fast as you can when you know you need to. Don't get too caught up in trying to attack the engineer or whatever. So, yes. I'm just rambling on at this point. There's not much to talk about. This is a little bit of a monotonous gameplay, but yeah. So I just set up a quick trap there. I thought I would catch that heavy out, but unfortunately no. Now here I'm in quite a tense moment. I spot this scout and I didn't want to send a projector right at him to blow up in my face, and unfortunately I get taken out. So I was just sandwiched there, nothing really I could do. So here it seems the enemy have set up a little teleporter off to the side of the battlefield, and this medic ubers me and I take out a teleporter and an opposing medic. And here I spot this heavy and another teleporter yet again, and I take him out with some quick pipes. Also, another really simple tip, if there's nothing to do and there's nothing to shoot at, always make sure that you've got a reloaded clip so that if anything approaches you in the midst of a battle, you're able to deal with it. So here, this will be Blue's last substantial push, and I nearly got taken out there by the heavy, but I was fortunate to live, so I have my great pocket pig there. I'm not quite sure how the demo and the scout got through our defensive line, but anywho. So now the gameplay is coming to a close, and I'd like to thank everybody for watching. I hope you got something out of it. Post a comment on what you thought and what I could have done better, and like and subscribe to see more. Thanks and goodbye.